What is up, everybody? Yes, I recently got approved to be a seller on GOAT. Now, unlike other apps and sites like StockX or eBay, where all you have to do is create an account and just start listing right away, on GOAT, you actually have to fill out one of their applications in order to get approved to be a seller. And you can only do it on the app because you have to take pictures for the application. I'll show you what I mean about that in a second. But as I mentioned, your boy recently got approved as a seller, and I'll show you how I did it. Let's go. All right, now all you gotta do is open up the GOAT app. Now, I actually had to recreate a second account because once you get approved to be a seller, your screen actually looks different, and I'll show you what I mean about that in a second. But once you download the app, you create an account, you gotta register. And once you register, you're gonna head over to the fourth button over, which looks like a label right here. You click on that, and then from here it'll say request to sell. Of course, the top step right here is your personal information, of course your name, phone number, and birth date. Now let me just put some random stuff in here. 503, just blah blah blah, 9999, birth date, just whatever, and then I'll click continue. Apparently, you must be at least 18 years old to be a seller on GOAT. I did not know that until I just randomly put in this date. So I guess I'll go back a few years. I'll go back to just click up here, change the years. I don't know. I'll just go back to 2000, I guess. Click OK. Should be 18 by now, right? Click continue. Now you go to return address. And of course, right here, you want to put the address, I guess, where you want your packages to be shipped back. For me, is my house or whatever. I mean, pretty self-explanatory, your return address. All right, and I entered the return address. Of course, I did that off camera. But once you do that, you are at the next step, which is seller 101. It'll give you a rough idea of what to do. It says, please review the following examples to avoid listing issues. And you go ahead and click OK. Now right here, it shows you an example of what GOAT considers worn shoes. It'll show you, you know, the outsole right here that has some, you know, little wear and tear on it, as you can see right there. Of course, then you have to, once you agree, you click agree at the bottom. Oh, you have to swipe through each photo. So you swipe over, and that's what a used outsole looks like. Of course, you can see scuffs or whatever. Of course, like it's been walked on. And then you have to swipe to the next picture, and GOAT considers these worn. Yes, they will take out the insoles of the shoe to see if there's wear and tear on the shoe, and if there is, they'll consider those shoes used. And to the fourth and last picture, they will show, you know, used lining. Of course, you can see right there, looks like, you know, the lint from a sock. I mean, if they see that on there, obviously somebody put their foot on there. So GOAT will consider those worn. If you agree to all that, you hit I agree. Now it'll take you to the next screen where it says GOAT considers these damaged boxes. Of course, it's all crunched up right here. You have to swipe through all four pictures. And on the third picture, they also consider boxes that are cut like this to be damaged as well. And they'll swipe over to the last picture. Now if the box does not have a lid, they will consider those boxes damaged, so you have to click I agree on that. And it takes you to this screen where it says GOAT considers these shoes defective, and it showed like right there on like the toe box some scuff marks. They consider those shoes defective because when you list these shoes, you have to list it as defective or used defective, new defective, or whatnot. And they're just showing you their definition of those words. So you swipe over to the next picture, and if it has chipped paint, that white part right there where the paint is chipped off, shoes with those are considered defective by GOAT. And if there's any tear in the prime knit, any holes or cuts like right there, they will consider those shoes defective as well. And the last picture, any discoloration on the shoes will be considered defective. So yeah, so then you click agree on all that. And then the seller verification policy will come up, and just quickly read that, and at the bottom you click I accept the policy. Now for the interesting part right here, we're actually messed up one time as well, and I'll show you what I mean. All right, under the test listing section, they pretty much want you to create a test listing. Now this shoe will not be put up for sale. You're just creating a list, a test listing for them to review. That way it shows you know what you're doing, and if you don't, they will email you and tell you, as they did with me. So anyways, we'll click OK and move forward. Now the first picture you want to take, of course, is of the tag, because they always go by the SKU only on the shoe, and this is an example picture of the tag, so you got to find this tag on the shoe. Now when you click OK, you're gonna have to type in the SKU of the shoe you are trying to list. Let me show you guys that right now. All right, now I actually test listed my Black Cement 3s. Now I've worn these before, and so I guess it doesn't matter because you're just doing a test list. And again, GOAT sells used shoes, so you can still, you know, list used shoes. But the SKU would be on the tag here. And if the tag is hard to see in the shoe, it's also on the box itself. Right here is the SKU. So I'm gonna enter that number into the app right now. So the SKU for the Black Cement 3 was 854-262-001. So it's 854-262-001. You want to click the men's size or whatever you're listing, and then you want to click the exact size you are listing. All right, now I actually advise doing a test listing for a new shoe. Even if your shoe is used, I would advise just clicking new, because when you actually click use, you have to take about 7 more pictures than just this one frame here. So when you do new, all you gotta do is, you can see the stencil there, hopefully you guys can see it right there, or not the stencil, the outline, whatever you want to call it, and then you just place your shoe, you know, or you place the outlining right where the shoe should be, and then you take a picture, and then that's it. Now I'll show you guys here, just for example, if you click use, like I said, it's just a test listing. I'm sure it doesn't matter if the shoe is new or used, I mean, but if you do click use, it is a lot more difficult. Let's say, you know, the box is still in good condition, of course, no defects, and I'll set the price to whatever. I'll just scroll here, click next. And as I mentioned, instead of this one picture right here, you're being asked to take more pictures because the shoe is used, so they want to see more pictures. Now this third box here wants to see the sneaker flat on the inner side, so of course it wants the shoe, you know, flipped over this, or actually this already had it on the inner side, this one on the inner side, you know what I mean. And then the next one it says take photo of the top of the sneakers, and you can see the stencil right there. So it's pretty much just asking you to lay the shoe out like this, and then you take the top of it, and then after that it says take the back of it, which is the heel, and then it wants to see the insole. So I mean, it's a lot of work just for a test listing. So I would highly advise doing the new listing where you just take one picture. Now this part is where it gets a little tricky. I was a little confused about this. The condition of the box. Now when they asked for the condition of the box, I pretty much just laid out the shoe box and I took a picture like this, because I thought they want to see the entire box. And I got an email saying to retake the picture, and my application did not get approved because of an incorrect picture. So they sent a sample picture in the email. Now all they want for the condition of the box is this right here, this screenshot. If you screenshot this, this is the picture that they want. Just the front of the box where the label and the size is showing, this exact side of the box, and that's it. And once you're done with taking all the pictures, it comes to this screen. Of course, I did not take all the pictures. I mean, it's self-explanatory. It gave you exact directions. You know, lay it on the inner side, and it wants to see the top or the insole. I mean, you pretty much get it. But once you're done with all that, it comes to here, and then you want to either submit or delete it and do it again. Now I'm not going to submit because I've already been approved on my other account. I created this account just for the sake of this video. And then last but not least, it's not glowing up because, you know, I deleted the application, or I deleted the test listing, so it's not glowing up. But once you submit the test listing, to me this is probably one of the most important parts, I think, that got me approved, is you want to link your social accounts. You click on that, and what I did was I linked my Twitter, my Facebook, and my Instagram, and you know, they want to check to see if you're a real person and if you have good reputation or not, from what it says. Once you get approved this entire sales screen, looks completely different. I'm gonna go ahead and sign it into my other account and I'll show you guys. But first, I'm gonna show you, once you get approved, they do email you right here. As it says right there, you've been approved to sell on GOAT, and it gives you all the stipulations with shipping and commissions and, you know, cancellations, any other questions you need to know. But let me head back to the GOAT app and show you how different that screen looks. All right, now I'm back on my account and I will click that same sell tab. And now look, it looks completely different. It is ready for me to post sneakers to sell. I just click up here, sell my sneakers, and it'll do a two-factor verification to make sure it's me. It also has, you know, shoes that you shipped. It has listings that you have on, consign listings, order. You could even put it on vacation mode. And it also has a seller rating. The default, once you get approved, is a seller rating of 90. And in order to get a bad seller rating, of course, it's cancellations or late shipments. And the worst seller rating you get, the higher the commission they take. It says right here, if you even drop 1 point, it'll go from a 9.5% commission to where they'll take 15% of your money, and so on. At 69, they'll take 20% of your money, and if you drop to 50, they'll suspend your account. And the better seller rating you get optional photos, you get to list multiple sizes. I don't see a decrease in commissions, but yeah, you get to list multiple sizes and add photos. And it looks like that's it. All right, hopefully that helped a lot of you guys. And if you have any questions, please leave it in the comment section below. Now my next step, now that I'm approved to be a seller, would be to sell a shoe. But currently I don't have any shoes I want to sell. But once I do, I would definitely post on GOAT, and I'll show you guys the process of selling on GOAT, from listing all the way to, you know, packaging, printing out the labels and shipping it out. So yeah, that will be for a future video. But if you guys enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you're new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe. And until my next video, see ya.
Bunch of sizes. Retails 120. Got these Jordan Trunners, the white one, $64.97. And on top of that, 30% off. Looks like the black pair too. $90. All right, hit the rack.